Freddy Krueger, you've done a lot of bad things in your life, right? Take a look at that camera right there. If you were to die today, would you go to heaven or hell?
As a character, I would say in hell. As a personal person, I think in heaven.
Yeah, you go to heaven. Why would you go to heaven as a personal person?
Because I'm a good person.
Good person? Mm-hmm. Let me ask you a few questions to see if that's true. Do you think you've kept the Ten Commandments?
Say it again, sir.
Do you think you've kept the Ten Commandments?
Not every time, but it's like this. Today, 2006, it's not like 2006 years ago when Jesus was born and everything. I'm a good person. I lie if I have to lie. This is the only thing what I do.
If you have to lie?
Yes.
So what would that make you if you've lied?
It's like business. If I have to sell myself, when they ask where I worked before, I have to lie sometimes to get a job, you know?
What do you call somebody who lies?
Liar.
Have you ever stolen anything?
When I was 17, maybe.
When you were 17, what would that make you?
Life, everything is back in the life.
What would that make you if you've stolen one thing?
You're a stealer.
What do you call that person?
Stealer, you say in American?
What do you call a thief?
Thief, yeah.
Thief. Have you ever misused God's name?
No.
You ever said, oh, use his name that way? That's blasphemy. It's very serious. Let me ask you one more thing. Jesus says, even if you look at a woman with lust, you've committed adultery with her already in your heart. Have you ever done that?
Yeah, I've done that too.
Yeah, that's called adultery, right? So what's your real name?
Claudio. Claudio?
Claudio, by your own admission, you're a lying, thieving, blasphemous adulterer at heart, and you have to face God on Judgment Day. If he were to judge you by the standard of the Ten Commandments, would you be found innocent or guilty?
Well, the way you see it, guilty.
So where do you think you would go, heaven or hell?
I told you, heaven.
What's that?
Heaven.
Okay, do guilty people go to heaven or hell?
They go to hell.
You just admitted that you were guilty, so where do you think you would go at this point in time, according to the standards I gave you?
I said, the way you see it, I go in hell.
Yeah, you'd go to hell. Check this out. The Bible says, all liars have their place in the lake of fire. No thief, no adulterer can enter the kingdom of heaven. Right now, you stand condemned before a holy God.
Okay.
You're under his wrath because of your sin. If you've broken just one commandment, that's sin. Okay, if you sinned one time, the penalty for that is all eternity in hell. Does that concern you at all? That you would, if you died right now, you have no hope? Right? You're under God's wrath?
Can I ask you a question?
Yes. Doesn't that concern you, though?
You've never done something bad in your life?
I've done them all. I broke all commandments.
You see?
Does that concern you?
Where are you going?
That's a good question. How about you? What are you going to do right now?
No, I ask about you. Are you going to heaven or in hell?
I'm going to heaven.
You're going to heaven? Why?
Let me tell you why.
Did you ever steal something?
Yes, I did.
So, how you call this person?
Let me tell you. This is the good news. Are you ready?
Yeah.
2,000 years ago, God did something that's absolutely fantastic.
He forgave the people.
You know what he did?
He forgave.
He sent his son, Jesus Christ, to die on a cross for all of your sins and my sins.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? If you put your trust in him, you turn away from your sins, that's called repentance, then he'll grant you everlasting life. It's a free gift. There's nothing you can do to earn it.
So he forgives you what you've done?
Because of what I've done. I've repented and believed in him. It's what he's done, nothing I've done.
I believe in God too.
Okay, but you have to believe in Jesus to forgive you of your sins.
I believe too, man.
Have you ever heard this? For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only son, that whosoever should believe in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. It's not God's desire that any should perish, all should come.
That's what I say. I believe. Okay. I believe all.
Okay. You got to give your life to him. It's more than just believing. I believe in George Washington was the first president, but he's not going to save me. Okay? You can just believe that Jesus Christ came to earth. If you haven't given your life to him, Jesus says you can't see the kingdom of heaven.
Every day before I go to sleep.
Doesn't matter. Unless you've been born again, you cannot see the kingdom of heaven. I want you to think about that, okay?
Yeah, okay.
And I thank you for your time. Let me give you something. Let me give you something right here. This is a Ten Commandments penny to remind you, you can't keep them except in your pocket. Okay?
Okay.
All right, ready?
Thank you.
What's your name again?
Claudio.
Claudio. Yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye.